Number 3. Special Agent Peter Strahm from Saw 4 and Saw 5. For the very first time you see him on screen, you just flat out know, oh, you're that guy. You're that guy that's gonna come around, be the one that throws his raid around, tries to solve the jigsaw case. You're that guy. And what is it with FBI agents in movies that are always dicks? I mean, seriously, why is that? Anyways, let's talk about Strahm. Honestly, in Saw 4, I feel like that was his better performance in the movie than Saw 5. With his interaction with Perez, like, he's the leader and Perez is the tag-along character, fallen thing, and just right out the bat in the dialogue, he just flat out explains everything to you, and you have to literally slow down and pay attention to what he's catching on. We don't know, like, what he knows. He's just there to spill exposition and get things going. We truly don't understand his character. And that's a problem I have with him. You truly don't know, like, what is the character of Strahm? Like, who is he? You know, why does he do what he does? Is he just does it for a reason? And we do see one scene in Saw 4, granted, that is compelling. Like, him trying to comfort Perez and him calling Perez his mother. To me, that's the only strong scene of that movie. But his interactions with Jill, and they're just trying to drag the movie along and just be the engaging force. It keeps our attention. It helps the audience follow along. Really doesn't help. And then we get to Saw 5, where basically the entire movie, he has survived and just does a tracheotomy, and he has to talk in a raspy voice through the entire movie. He talks in this voice. Imagine this voice right here for 90 minutes. And then he has to talk out loud to the audience and give his thoughts out. For we, the audience. You see my point. Y'all see my point. But anyways, yeah, Saw 5 really kind of does him just a disservice as a character standpoint. He's just there to be the cop along, trying to figure out what all was going on with Hoffman. And to me, that just doesn't make him very interesting. So, what a way to bring in another cop, right? I'm sure there'll be more on this list.
With Strahm, I have to somewhat disagree. I felt like his performance, or at least his character, was fairly refreshing in Saw 4. He didn't really need a whole lot from him. In fact, other than how that movie ended and where we were left at the end of that movie with the autopsy and the fact that Hoffman was going to be the last man standing, it's like, okay, we're never going to have to see Perez and Strahm again. They're going to bring in somebody else, or whatever's going to happen here. Like, John's dead. This was happening at the same time, and now it's going to have some kind of time jump or whatever. They didn't do that. And then what they did with his character throughout Saw 5 was just so obnoxious. You talk about him being an exposition machine in the fourth film is nothing compared to what they did in the fifth film. One of the things that I've talked about on YouTube, and I got my start on doing with YouTube, was the whole resurgence of Dragon Ball. But his performance and his entire character, his purpose in Saw 5, just reminds me so much of a joke from Dragon Ball Z Abridged, where they go back into flashback and Frieza tells Vegeta about all this other stuff that his father was doing before he blew up Planet Vegeta, and then it cuts to Vegeta and he's like, how did you know the parts that you weren't there for? And that's exactly all of Saw 5. He goes to these locations, or he's not even in the locations, and he sees in his head, there's no other way to interpret it, he sees what happens in a flashback, the way that it happened, when he would have absolutely no context for those things. And it's confusing. And the Saw franchise has always had a problem with flashbacks, but he became the living embodiment of bringing up useless flashbacks in the fifth film. And it's one of the reasons it just really doesn't work. So honestly, that's why he's this far down the list. They ruined his character in Saw 5 for what I would argue was a fairly good turn in the fourth film.
And if you're watching this, Scott Patterson, we're sorry.
We're awesome. So, yeah, we're so sorry. You're awesome. Like, He's awesome.
You're awesome at Gilmore Girls.
Yeah, Gilmore Girls is great. Like, he's good in Saw 4. Like, he's a good character, but geez, just talking to yourself in a raspy voice. You were supposed to be the hero. It just doesn't work, man.
Sorry, Scott. We love you.